Hello, my name is Charlotte Sandal-Beck. I'm one of the investigators in the study of automatic oxygen control with O2matic during admission with COPD. In this video, I'd like to present the results of the study. O2matic is a closed-loop system which continuously measures the patient's oxygen saturation by pulse oximetry and adjusts the oxygen flow to maintain the saturation within a target interval. O2matic is designed for hospital use, and in this study it was used on respiratory wards for patients with COPD. In O2matic, any saturation range between 85 and 100% can be set. Also, the oxygen flow can be set between 0 and 15 liters per minute. If the saturation falls below the target range or if the pulse rate is outside normal, an alarm will sound. In the O2matic trial, we included 20 patients admitted with COPD in a crossover trial with 4 hours of automated control with O2matic and with 4 hours of manual control where the nurses controlled the oxygen delivery. The primary outcome of this study was time within target saturation interval with O2matic and with manual control. Secondary outcomes were time with severe and moderate hypoxemia and time with saturation above target. Furthermore, we examined patients' perception of automated oxygen control. The results of the study was that O2matic maintained the oxygen saturation in the prescribed interval in 85% of the time, and manual control only kept the saturation in the right interval for 47% of the time. Especially time with severe hypoxemia, defined as saturation below 85%, was markedly reduced with O2matic from 18 to 1%, and time with moderate hypoxemia was reduced from 25 to 9%. Patients' perception of O2matic oxygen control was very positive. The main complaint was the limitation of movement due to the wired pulse oximetry. The sense of safety was very high, and 92% of the patients felt completely safe with O2matic. In conclusion, we found that O2matic was able to effectively control the oxygen saturation according to international guidelines for oxygen administration. The oxygen was controlled significantly better in the O2matic than with the manual control, and in particular, episodes with hypoxemia was markedly reduced with the O2matic. Further studies of O2matic will examine O2matic control for a longer duration to test if O2matic can speed up weaning from oxygen and reduce length of hospital stay. We also aim to examine if O2matic can reduce the workload of the nurses with patients hospitalized due to COPD and other conditions of hypoxemia.